毛玉もこもこ西やふわふわドドドド布団にくるまり今日もおやすみ明日のことでドキドキしたりそわそわしたりしないでゆっくり何も考えないで寝よう眠れない夜に寄り添う狼がいるよ温かいミルクに蜂蜜が溶けるように Good sleep darling 狼もふもふ毛玉もこもこミシやふわふわドドドド布団にくるまり今日もおやすみJust to find that special day. Have I found everybody a fun assignment to do today? When you're here, everything that we do is fun for them anyway.
ダイヤルしてほしい
寂しさに気づいてた。
Hello. Sorry. Hold up. One moment. Ah! Stop blocking me. I didn't do anything. What up, Diop? Yes, you did it right.
Are you home?
I think you're home.
You're not home.
For a moment, I was actually on Twitter and I lost track. I was listening to stream, and then just scrolling through Twitter, I didn't realize my song was over. So I got distracted a bit. What was that? What was the double bonk? I'm gonna play other song. Oh, my song's not playing, why?
Hug me!
No huggies. Oh?
Hug me!
No huggies. Hi, Hat Enjoyer. I see you. Hold up, give me a moment. Uh-huh. Where is that song?
Hug me!
Oh my god, it's so loud. Oh my god, it's so loud. That's super loud. There.
It's even simple.
声が気がする。 Oh, did my headset work? Does it work? QQ Krabby, hello. Where am I? Wait, I'm lost. I think music is too loud for you guys, right? Is it too loud? Just tell me. It's a bit too loud for me. I also kind of want to pee, but it's fine now. All right, thank you. Thank you for telling me. Oh shit. We're supposed to do art. A tad bit quiet? Is it quiet? Is music quiet? Really? How about now? Audio is such a tricky thing on stream. Like, it kept on changing because I have my own headset volume controller, and under the volume mixer on my PC, I lowered down the Chrome sound volume, and then under audio output, the source OBS, I adjusted it. So it's very tricky to get the right like volume. For now, it's perfect for me, but I'm not sure about how it's gonna be reflected in stream, so... Yeah, tricky stuff indeed. Yeah, you're correct. Anyway, today I'm thinking of... Ne futari wa shinjite ru kana. I'm gonna do art. There. I see. 見えなくて. Okay, we'll pull up. There you go. Okay. So, we're gonna finish... Probably gonna try to finish the Badru art that I'm working on. Oh, hello, Nico. Welcome back. I actually was watching Kitty's stream. And then she talked about she couldn't recall when like the first time we both like talked. She said it's true Nana. And I said, oh, it's actually true Nico. You called me to draw both you and Nana. Oh shit. Okay. Okay, let's do it in like white color, and I'm gonna shade it. And I feel like, because we have the overall look right now, so we can actually resize everything. I'm going to resize it. Let's make it uniform first. Ah, how about the season? I don't think I need the assistant drawing. I'm gonna turn it off, the drawing guide. Yay, now it's big. So she said. Oh, I saw you redeeming some stuff. Wait, on Kitty's stream? I'm actually late to my stream. I was playing to... Naze daro koi no shikata sae sukkari wasurete ta. Deai wa
いつか来る別れの始まりといつの間にか決めつけていた。
Sorry, I love this song.
汚れたスニーカーのほどけた紐結んでくれた何かもあなたの笑顔朝日を浴びてときめいた急に愛されていいから愛したいわけじゃないまっすぐ愛する勇気をくれたねこれからの旅に二人今誓うよ何があってもこの手離さないずっと
Okay, I have to finish at least the first verse. I was actually late to my stream because I planned to stream a lot earlier today.
いつもの景色も特別に見えてくる
I was planning to stream early so I could end early because I want to spend time with someone but apparently I started a bit late、I'm sorry I was just looking in Kitty's stream I was just doing my own thing and I got distracted
最後のピース見つけたよ大きなあなたの背中私守られついてつく永遠に
How are you guys doing by the way?
こんなに回り道したけどまっすぐ愛する自信を持ってたね
Got distracted by the sweet ears. Oh, it's actually tingling. My ears were tingling. I can feel it. No, I have such a sensitive, motion sickness. What do you call that? Phantom sense. So I can actually feel around my neck, but she was like whispering to me and, you know, knowing me, I mean, you guys probably have known already. I'm pretty gay. I'm pretty gay and that made my heart pit-a-pat, you know? Like,
doki-doki するよ愛したいわけじゃないまっすぐ愛する勇気をくれたね明日からの夢に二人今行かうよ何があってもとみそらさないいいから愛したいわけじゃない
Alright, anyway, we're going to work on shading today?
ドドド何があっても離さないずっと
Should we use like this color instead and then just change the gradient or like the put and multiply instead? Try. Transform. Oh, okay, multiply, but like it's too dark. Oh, you guys will know this song.
Iradachi wo doko ni butsukeru ka sagashiteru aida ni owaru hi sora wa hairoその先は何も見えない
Welcome back, Gurin! Double shake it. What do you mean spitting bars? Oh, actually in the playlist there is like some sort of song that is pretty fast, so. それで得られたもの大事に飾っておけるの。でも明日と進まなきゃならない。だからこの歌うよ。泣いてる君こそ孤独な君こそ正しいよ人間らしいよジュージュージュー落とした涙が嘘じゃない本当の僕らを Ari curtains. Why is it so sad? My song choices, even if I go karaoke with my wife, they're always very sad. Like,all the Westlife songs, Kelly Clarkson, Avril Lavigne, Adele, Westlife, I said Westlife again. Like, they're like very sad, because like, I like songs like those. Oh. Da da da! Oh, this is not the karaoke version. Kimi no toriko ni na. That wasn't. Ah! I don't know how to sing this, but I feel like you guys might enjoy the song.Just let me know if it's too loud, alright? I feel like my mic's a bit loud right now. My own mic, my own voice is a bit loud. You guys, just emo. Calling me emo? You're damn right! I'm hearing doubles, so I'm not sure where it's coming from. Can you hear that?Can you hear double? I feel like I'm hearing double. Hold up, hold up. I feel like it's not double? Oh, it is double. It's double for me, sorry. There you go. 変わることのない愛をくれるのは誰? Ask us is my darling. 私の最後はあなたがいい。あなたとこのままおさらばするように死ぬのがいいわ死ぬのがいいわサンドン飯よりあんたがいいのにあんたこのままおさらばするよか Oh my god! This is not rap, by the way それでも時々上つくマンハート直してもそばすベイベーYeah, baby. It's too low. You know, they say there's a voice practice to figure out what your range is when singing. So you do like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.10, and then you just talk normally. So that's your range. And this is my range. Is this a like rap? Oh my gosh. Say bye bye. Yeah, yeah. 私の最後はあなたがいい。あなたとこのままおそらばするより死ぬのがいいわ。死ぬのがいいわ。飯よりあんたがええのよあんたとこのままおそらばするよか死ぬのがいいわ Oh my god, bald! Ryan, welcome back! I love the little emo buns around this. Oh yeah, yeah, me too. I actually really like the new plugin, the new BTS plugin. I just came back from Suicide Street. Oh, you watch Hollow Libraries and Descendias? I never watch the corporate VTubers. I don't watch corporate VTubers at all. So people are like very caught up with what's going on with Hololivers, with you know, the corporate VTubers, right? I wasn't, because I didn't start my VTubing journey with them or because of them. It was completely accidental for me. Like I started VTubing completely unrelated with any corporate VTubers. I wasn't aware of any. I wasn't even aware of like the usual trend among VTubers or what the norm was. So I was like kind of like a late bloomer, late bloomer in terms of VTubing. But I kind of liked that I started that way because it was pretty fresh. I had so much fresh ideas, like nothing. I wasn't constricted with anything, I didn't even have Twitter. I streamed for like a couple of months, but I didn't have my Twitter. And then one of my VRC fam was like, hey, you should create a Twitter account. It's like very, very, like, it's gonna be good for you. So I did, and I kinda understood what they meant. That's how you actually connect or socialize or, you know. But I kinda like miss my first, set myself when I first started, because looking back, I was like, oh, she, you know, she was so fresh, so full of ideas, wasn't really scared to do anything, like literally just enjoyed herself in stream, which was why I always look back to my old clips, my old VODs, because that reminded me why I started this in the first place. My voice range, I don't know how much I smoky today. Hey, smoky, smoky, bad, bad. Ah, Tubby! Yo, Tubby's actually here. Tubby, I'm taking attendance today. You're late. You're late by 10 minutes. Good morning, how was your sleep? Late boomer? No. Bloomer. I don't bloom. I mean, I bloom, but kind of late. Oh, I like Suise when she played Tetris. That is so sweet. Who is? How was your sleep? Alright, moving on to our next song. I'm gonna skip that song. Okay. Oh, nope. Okay. Doo-doo. Doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo. Bam 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 bam. They say laser blues become the most beautiful flowers. Now I end up, you know, just wilted away. I'm like grass. The tall grass, but I'm actually not that tall. I thought I was tall, but I wasn't. And I was like hidden among all those grasses. Boomers. I didn't say boomers, I said bloomers. Hello, how's you? Hello, now I'm like holding my pee right now.
Hi, Mistia Hirdus. There was a song called No Spoilers, Please. I'm not hip with the kids since I was not aware. What song is that? English? English song? This rationalization came when I listened to Sodom. I remember how old that is? Oh, blue. You guys are just gonna vibe with me today, okay? We're vibing today. That's like our main goal for the day. Also, I really wanna pee. But I'm holding them. I really wanna finish watching this anime though. I always like speak highly of the anime, but I actually haven't finished the whole thing. Because I feel like once I finished it, I'll be like sad. And I'll feel like, oh, I can't move on, you know? Hi, Missy. Hello, introverted corpse. Welcome back. How are you doing? Good morning. What? Use a fishnet? Oh, you did know? You did know I have fishnet? Okay, watch. Damn! Da 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 Oh yeah! With Kitty on my screen! Oh yeah! Hit me, girl! Please don't tell Kitty, I'm pretty weird and gay. I don't want to scare her away! Thanks for the meal. Oh, you're welcome. Anytime. Little did you know that the current drawing I'm doing right now, the Fedora, is actually my Christmas model design. It's in the works right now. I'm so excited. I hope it will be rigged in time. Just hopefully it will be rigged in time. I'm like a bit nervous because of that. Genki de ite ne. Snack time. Go pee, we'll wait. Nah, it's fine. Do 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 do. Itsuka iru. Do 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 do. I feel like I should draw like a wolf bumper mark here. It's ours, right?
さよならバイバイ。
啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦啦Probably that, and then I'm gonna add another layer. especially around this area, like holding area thingy. Do you use a VR to help it sleep? Does it really help? I'm thinking in buying a Quest 2 to help it sleep. Okay, okay. I should like properly talk about that. For starter, my worst insomnia was 2 years ago. It's always been hard for me to sleep. You can ask Nya Nya, she's been my roommate for 4 years. A little bit over 4 years, I don't know, 4 years. She knows how sleep is very hard for me to achieve. Like, the initial stage of trying to sleep is so hard for me. Like, unlike Nya Nya, she can fall asleep immediately, or like, she can just fall asleep randomly. I can't. I have to like, be in proper environment, be in a proper mindset, making sure everything is like, all the lights turn off. No, like, distraction. But even in those condition or environment, I still struggle to sleep. Since I was still very young, I can't remember when, but very, very young. Like single digit year young. And it's gotten worse, and the worst was definitely 2 years ago. Around October, November, even before that, to be honest. And to the point that I had to depend on sleeping pills. There was like one really intense period that couldn't take it anymore. I started to, you know, hallucinate. Hearing things, that was when I knew, oh, it's pretty fucked up. So I went to the doctor and checked. I was diagnosed anyway, but like I went to the doctor and talked to him and was like, I can't sleep. And he, actually two doctors, they prescribed me more sleeping pills, and even taking sleeping pills took a toll on me, like, it will like make me fall asleep for 4 days, kind of. Like, it's that bad for me, so I don't really want to depend on it. But because I was such in a bad state, my doctor was like, just take it, try to relax your mind and your body, right? Like, your body needs to sleep. So I took it sometime. I even cut the pills in half sometime, because I don't want it to be too strong. And after that, it was a pandemic still, and a lot of my friends started to have VR, and I was looking into purchasing some for myself, as a gift for my graduation to myself. And I bought it. I got a Rift S, and, because my motion sickness is really bad in VR, I can't stand up playing for long. I can't, even sitting up is a struggle for me, so, the best way is for me to lay down, but it's so comfy because I feel like it puts a light pressure on my head, on my forehead, on my head, literally. So because of that pressure, maybe it helped me to, like, it made me sleepy. It helped calm me down. It's as if you getting massage. I don't really recommend. It actually depends on individual itself, but in VR scenes, VR chat scenes, there are a lot of people who like doesn't care if they don't care if they fall asleep in VR. So that means that it's comfortable enough for them to do. If you somehow have like sleep problems, like sleep, how do you say that? Sleep apnea, like you can't really breathe well. So I don't recommend, but just solely to fix your sleep problem, I don't think you should get VR unless if you're really keen on trying VR. Quest 2 is a great choice. It's not as heavy as the other VR headset. At least it's not as heavy as the old one, the Rift S, Oculus Rift S. Quest 2 is pretty light. And I think it, you know, lessen the risk of you being, if you don't use a Oculus Link and if you use a virtual desktop, like me, it lessens the risk of you being, you know, strangled with all those cables. So, yeah, that's my opinion. But it does help me to sleep at times, but I wouldn't say I use it a lot just to sleep these days. I will definitely fall asleep in VR if it's not hot. If it's hot, then no, I would still, you know, have problem to sleep. You can also ask courage. Oftentimes we are watching a movie or like anime, I just fell asleep. Anyway. Been in all those stages too. Yeah, I mean, I envy I envy people that can fall asleep so easily. I actually feel jealous. Like, how can you sleep? That's such a hard thing to do. And people were like, you've been drinking coffee so much. You had a lot of caffeine intake. No, even days, weeks without coffee, if I wasn't working, it's still a struggle for me. It's just me and sleep problem. You go to the place that takes. Yes, you should borrow it from someone else, or maybe go to the gaming center that offers VR. Try it out first. I would recommend you borrowing it first. Actually, just probably a week. Get used to VR because you will feel dizzy for the first time. Definitely. I love this song. Dun dun, I will go pee after this song is over. Sometimes 3 days without physically cannot sit, so I'm researching some things to help, and coffee help. You know what might help? Actually what helped me bit by bit trying to like coming out from that really bad stage of me unable to sleep for days. It comes and goes these days, which is, thank God. Hey, let me pause again. Because it's such an important topic for me. I can understand your struggle. I truly can. It sucks. Unable to sleep, right? It sucks a lot. So, in my opinion, how I try to help myself with it is, tire myself out, definitely, the whole day. Sometimes the more I tire myself out, I can't sleep either, so it's just the same. But at least we can try. Like, you know, imagine yourself having a checklist of you know, efforts to sleep. And have warm shower before bed, which is why I prefer to shower before bed these days instead of like, you know, like late, like usual person, normal human being, 6 p.m. or 7 p.m. and get a shower. But I don't do it anymore because I feel like a shower before, right before bed is like the best for me because my body is all cooled down and all. And get a lot of good pillows and blankets. Get the weighted blanket if you can. Probably it will help you as long as you don't get suffocated or like feeling really hot. Changing your bed sheets sometimes help as well. Like imagine shopping for a new one, like you get yourself excited for it to sleep. Try to sleep before bed to exhaust your body. Actually, it's not recommended for you to exercise, as in real exercise. Like, let's say you exercise doing jumping jacks, and then you go to sleep immediately. That's not recommended because you might have a heart attack. It might induce a heart attack. So, you need time to cool down still. But another type of exercise is good because it releases the hormones that might help you to sleep, if you know what I mean. And honestly, that's what I've been doing. Anyway, you meant the other type of exercise, right? Bro, you're trying to do it for me. Anyway, oh my god. I got bombed. Oh no. Actually, Japanese people shower before bed. They shower with really, really hot water. Like there's their hot water settings. If you've been to Japan and like been to like a common household or like ryokan. Like a Japanese, public place to shower, if you guys know what I mean. Their hot shower setting is really hot. It's kind of hot because they believe that hot water, if you shower with hot water or like if you bath with hot water, it will help you to get rid of your inner heat. It will like get rid of your inner heat after such a long day of like and all that. It will help you to sleep nicely as well. So, I mean, I shower with really hot water too, so I like it. It's very nicey. Get all cozy and just to stay up until 4 a.m. because it's just me unable to sleep. Another weird thing that's been helping me to sleep all these years are like listening to snores. back in university, yes. While I was dating my ex for like 5 years, we were like stay in the call and like fall asleep in the call, and he would like usually snore, and that actually helped me. And when we broke up, the first thing I was like really sad about was me unable to hear him snore and help me sleep. Like, I just realized how much of a help he was to me when... Exposed. Yeah, that... I feel like people might find me weird, but... Maybe because I feel safe. Like, you listening to someone sleeping, or like, knowing that they are there makes you feel safe, and like, I'll put my guts down, kind of, like, naturally. I'll feel safe, and like, just sleep to it. It wasn't enough, you know, if it wasn't enough, I'll just exercise before bed. Probably like 3 to 4 times before bed. Oh gosh. Oh. We're
is my song.
Yay! Someone watching you sleep? No, 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 it's not just anyone. That's the thing. You have to do it with someone you really, really trust. I listen to Misa's dreams. Really?
まだ山積みそれでも太陽信じてるメロディーにじむ汁ね柔らいきたまでとても anyone ならないね
Wait, why his snore help you sleep? Yeah. I still do it till this day. I need someone to snore for me. I mean, not just anyone. I was married years ago. Some of my ex sleeping do help me sleep. When we broke the first thing, I noticed was shit. I'm not gonna say anymore. Yes, 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 actually yes. Yes, Rubin. I feel like we're pretty similar in that sense, Rubin. And I didn't know you were married, to be honest. I see you struggle now. Like, I enjoy being alone, but like these days, I want someone to be alone with. No, 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 you're recording. No, 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 I met someone else. It's just I had to have someone to sleep with them. And I'll snore. And then I'll wake up. I'll wake him up for noises. Can I post a YouTube link? I think you can. You can try. What are you sussing about? Anyway, the song ended, so I'm gonna pee. I'll be right back. It'll take me like a minute. Hello? Oh no! Oh no, never mind. You can try. Damn! Messages were deleted. Timed out. Oh, sorry, sorry. Thanks, right? Yeah, I was married for 2 years, but we were really young. So it didn't work. Oh, how old were you? I feel like young couple who married when am I saying? Oftentimes it's gonna be difficult for young couples married early. Yes. Yeah. No, I'm gonna say more. I'm just glad I escaped that situation. I almost got married early, so. No, the idea of getting married is just scared, probably. I don't want to go through that. Maybe I don't trust people enough to be able to give someone that bond, maybe?
because I feel like, once I gave it away, and then it's broken. I'm totally gonna break. That's it for me. I barely survived before, so like, I don't think I can go through it again. I'm doing this for myself. Respecting your limits, it's part of treating yourself. Mm-hmm. 맞아요, 맞아요. You're right. I strongly feel like you don't necessarily have to be married to be in love. It's such a huge responsibility, like, guys aren't just, you know, partners. Guys are gonna be life partners. Actually going through thick and thin. Thick and thin. It's not only thick, but thin as well. Wait, it's only thin? Eh? What? Feelings change. People can fall out of love, but people can also bring back the love. So I feel like that part people always forgot. So once they fall out of love, they just stop trying. If it's a healthy relationship, then I don't think you should stop trying. But if it's like abuse, or you know, obviously abuse. That's the only thing. There's so much abuse between two people in a marriage. Maybe it's not attractive to me because of that. Like, I feel like I see the cons more than the pros. So, I mean, it's nice to have someone, right? We can call family, and we can depend on each other, and truly be honest. Letting your guards down, I feel like that's what's important, because I don't often let down my guard. I still have my guards up with anyone I am with. It's just to protect myself most of the time. But yeah, it's scary. Like this relationship advisory. Oh, are you needing some? You're totally right. And hold on, I've got a live thing that some space can be better to relationship because you're not filming the vlog of your marriage. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Really, you, when your life gets sour, you don't want to get into it anymore, have a second chance. Takes time to adjust again. Mm. But I honestly think that every single day, when you discover more stuff about the person you're living with, and it takes true love, to like find something that strengthens your love for the other person every single day. Like, every day gives you more reason to live it. Like, you're never like running out of stuff. about running out of ideas. Like, you always find something new, and if you still love them, that you love them, that person, for who they are. Not because of what they put out to you, what they show you, what they thought, what you thought they are. Marriage, I suppose, they are a lot, to be honest. But it's just that, for me, has a lot more cons and pros for me. Sex every day. Unprotected sex every day. That's where things will go wrong. If people feel like they have to get married just to have sex. You know how wonderful it is to use toys? Knowing Croat, can't think of a single pro to marriage. Can't even see you on your knees. If you want to start a family, marriage is probably meant for you. If you feel like you will do an everlasting love, like personally one person for you in your entire life, you can do marriage. If you somehow want to survive the current economy and wanna, you know, get the benefits from marriage in terms of taxes and all those, marriage is probably meant for you too. For now, for now, at this point, at this stage of my life, it's not meant for me. I was really in love before, but I wanna get married and spend the rest of my life with that person. I was 19 years old, very young. I wanna have babies. We were talking about how we're gonna build our own small football team. I was ready to be a freaking human machine, a baby maker. But you know, you learned. When I was married, I got back to home from work, and all I could think was, I just want to play LOLs. Well, my idea of marriage is a bit different. It's more of a companionship. Because as private as I can get, I really want a companion. I want the presence of a person with me. And that person absolutely has to have no judgment towards me. でもそんなんじゃダメ、もうそんなんじゃほら、心がすりゃもっともっと、ドドドラドドドラドドドラドド、wrong song. But, ちょっと待って。トゥントゥントゥントゥントゥン。Oh, I love this song.Oh, what was I talking about? I forgot. That song threw me off guard. Did I talk about like being a baby maker? No, I don't even want to bring a child to this world, man. But I was often being told that I would be a good mother, even though I don't feel like I am going to be a good mother. I behave like a mother around my friends in real life, like especially my girls. In my school bag, or university bag, I have every single thing. I have like all those emergency stuff, like people will like, if they ask me, I probably have the item. You have tissue, you have wet tissue, you have wet wipes, do you have like plastic, do you have Band-Aid, do you have this, do you have that? Yes, I do, I bring everything because I feel like I have to take care of people around me. Childhood trauma, not being taken care of. Oh yeah, I was talking about my partner, right? Having to, have judgment, absolutely, have full support. Like, even though I'm wrong, they will like, still defend me, kind of. I want undivided support from them, but at the same time, they have to guide me and teach me. Like, we will have to teach each other, that's how we grow as person. That's what I long for in life, and that's good enough for me. What do you mean toxic? The relationship is different from back there. I think with you, someone really loving is not the same that you need to bear memories more than love and doki doki. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I agree. It's different. Thank you. Mr. Mommy confirmed. Well, my high school friends will call me mommy sometimes. I behave like one. I cook for them. I make sure they have everything that you need. If you feel uncomfortable, like, I will change seats. You know, those kind of stuff, like, I will definitely do it. Like, natural caretaker, kind of. So, from my partner, what I usually want is also to be taken care of. Like, imagine like living that kind of life. You will bound to be exhausted in that position, and sometimes I just wanna put my guard down, relax, and have someone take care of me during some days that I really needed that. And that's how I'll recharge. But most of the time, I feel like I'm my own pillar, so I have to be strong myself. And I can't crumble down, because no one's gonna do that for me. That's probably just mindset. That's how I survive. I decide to go commit mass murder, expect full support from a significant other. Shut the fuck up. Not in that sense, but I mean, the significant other has to have this mindset. Ah, she might have did it for a reason. There must be a reason why she did that, you know? I mean, what else is the reason people, you know, committing those stuff if they're not under some sort of pressure or something's bugging them or they're a cycle? It could be cycle, but not enough. PMS isn't fun, so that is it. Shut the fuck up! You don't have PMS, you don't know how it is, how we have fluctuating hormones, lack of testosterone, progesterone, whatever. I'm not good at bio, so. Ah, 남자는 몰라, 진짜. Like, men doesn't know shit, man. I'm glad I don't have severe PMS physical symptoms. I do have them sometimes. Actually, my previous one was pretty bad. Like, you know why I hadn't, like, stream for a couple of days, because we have PMS, a pre-menstrual syndrome. I'm so bad. We have during the period, and so we have after the period. That just doesn't like leave us. The only normal time we have is one freaking week after. So like, let's say we have 4 weeks, right? Pre is the first week, during is the second week, after is the third week. So my normal week is the fourth week, with no sickness, with no, you know, weird hormones acting up and all those. Only on the fourth week, sometimes it's even shorter than that. So
My kind of PMS is usually the headache before, after. The headache is no kidding. It will definitely mess with me. There are days I could not stand up or like get out of my bed. It was that bad. The cravings, oh my god, before, the week before, the cravings are so bad. And then the during itself, I will like stop eating. Like, I knew for a fact it's just period stuff. I will like don't have any like appetite to eat. And the after, oh my god, the bloating. The bloating will lead to migraines, which what happened to me last few weeks. It was so bad. It was so bad, like, it's uncomfortable. I'm constant bleeding, of course. One of my waifus usually will faint. So I'm like used to dear friends coming by to get me from my class and told me, she fainted. So I'm the one usually will like handle calling their parents and all that, because it was so bad. My sister usually can't move at all. From her bed, she can't get out. She has to take the pill. I don't like taking the pill. We have the pill to reduce the pain because it will disrupt my blood flow and my hormones. So I usually don't want to take the pill. One of my wife also has to get on birth control pill just to regulate her freaking period. I think it's easy for us. It's not. But I remember back in the day, maybe it's probably why I find it really hard for me to want to leave this relationship, because it took care of me so well during those days, especially when I had my period and stuff. It like drive to me and brought me warm food sometimes, because he knows I'll have super bad migraine. Super bad headache and all of the body aches and all that. It's painful for me. So like he would like massage my head and let me fall asleep for a bit, because knowing pain couldn't sleep well, and give me chocolate. There's like one specific brand that he really liked. Like he knows that it will help. Just why I always have a stash of chocolate somewhere for a period of time for when the craving is back, because they help with the headaches. That's one thing I could appreciate besides all those cons. I have a friend who cannot live without the pills. Exactly. You know people can bleed more than 7 days, right? So glad my cycle is normal. I'm pretty breathable. It's gonna fuck your hormones and shit. She's like, I'm already fucked up, you don't know how it hurts. Yeah, it does. Oh yeah, look at that. Maybe we'll do this article. Don't call it snaps, man. Jupiter and Mars. Oh my god, I'm indecisive as fuck. Kiss me. Oh my god, it's getting worse. Yeah, I'm good. No, I meant the color. Deciding the color. Getting worse. I can't choose. This rate, I'm gonna take so much time just to decide the color I want to use. We actually had such a good just chatting. I love talking, like a lot of topics. It intrigues me how different mindsets are. Just reminds me how each and every one of us have different upbringings, so no one is to blame, you know? Everyone can be educated, everyone can learn. Is this French? It is French. Listen to the resume. What the heck? The subtitle is in French. Am I too close to my mic? I feel like I might be. I like your chat too comfy and friendly. Am I? I have a question. Do you prefer comfy streamers doing art, you know, or do you prefer just, you know, the huge? Let me pause. You prefer those, the ones with really huge mummy energy, the ara energy, the Louis the 18 plus kind of one, unapproachable kind of like really sisterly energy, the fuck? Big sister energy kind of stream? Because I find that if you really don't want minors in your stream or minors in your community, having that big sister slash big mummy energy sometimes is the best choice. Because you are prone to attract more mature people instead. And you might feel safer to talk about a lot more stuff, adult stuff. And comfy, very wholesome kind of streamers usually will attract every kinds of people, including those in the below 18, right? Le Mr. Monge, le croissant. It's not croissant, it's croissant! Depend on the streamer. Could be, could be.
Mine, probably, if I were to do it all over again, my first mistake is letting those under 18 or really, really young people wander around my community. I should have been clear in the beginning that I prefer to be plus 18, even though I'm pretty confident. Pretty comfy. I'm pretty comfy.
Wakatta. Sore demo hikari wo oi tsuzukete iku yo.
Even though what I do is just basically gaming, doing art. Doing really wholesome art. I don't do good art on stream. So, like, there's no reason for, like, minors not welcome here. But I feel like over time, I don't feel like it's such a safe place for people really under 18 to be on Twitch overall. But also, most comfy streamers or really wholesome streamers usually get a lot of trauma dumping people in their chat, which is such a toll on their mental health as well. Like, imagine you guys telling me such heavy stuff when all I planned for the day, like, it's not easy for me to click on that start streaming button just like that and stream. It's not that easy as it seems. It took a lot of like mental courage to press that and to like fully prepare. Probably plan something, right? Just for some random ass people suddenly heavily trauma dump and be like, I'm such in a bad place right now. I wanna, you know, KMS. I wanna commit scooter ankle because I feel like people don't like me. People rejected me. People do this. People do that. Or like, I went to this streamer's stream. They hated me. They banned me. They timed me out. Blah, 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 blah. You just suddenly said that to me when I was just, all I wanna do is just vibe to music and do my art. Back in the days, I get that a lot. So much people trauma dumb. Some of them even feel like, even though I said like I was very, this is the tricky part of being a streamer. It's like the parasocial relationship. Like, it bound to happen. Welcome back, boy! Oh, thank you! Glad you're liking that. And I wasn't really clear, even though it's not only with like regular people who don't stream, with some streamers, or even some people who just started streaming, right? And I mean, I have to be nice. Obviously, I have to be nice on stream. I can't be like, yo, Kurt, what the fuck is wrong with you? Why are you here? Why are you just here? You're late. I can't just say that. I mean, I just said that. Sorry, Kurt. I saw your name, so I had to tease your name. But of course I'll be like, hi Kurt, how are you? How are you doing? How was your weekend? And then you tell me about your weekend. I was like, oh, I hope you had fun with that, right? It's just generate conversation most of the time. And some people think that it's a cue for them to be super friendly to me, to the point that they have to DM me, have to talk to me constantly without, like, there's no real connection there at all. Like, I'm very careful at picking people to talk to every day because my energy, for God's sake, my energy, social energy is really, really low. In terms of battery, I only have like one
per 5 battery. And I usually reserve that to people I really want to spend with. I plan to spend with. Right? That's just me. Because using up my energy. It's really hard. Streaming is different though. Because I'm the one doing the talking. I have the control here, obviously. I can respond to people I want. Or choose not to, which is why streaming is perfect for me. My favorite kind of stream is when I can feel some legitimacy in the stream. Like, it doesn't matter what I'm doing, but that doesn't matter what I'm like, oh, thank you. You think too highly of me. Oh, really. Thank you so much. But sometimes it's our highlight. Exactly. Don't trauma them. You can share news, but you don't trauma them. Like, for example, right? Quote came by and be like, hi, I just want to stop by and say hi. I can't really stay on the stream today because my dog passed away. But my dog just died. My dog didn't survive the surgery. I hope you all have a nice day. And I'll talk to you some other time. That's fine. That's fine. That's sharing news. And I was like, oh, understandable. Thank you for letting me know. I'm sorry that happened to you. Not like, hey, I'm so sad right now. Why? You have to ask me, why are you sad? My dog just died. Can you do this for me? I can you cheer me up? That's when I feel like I feel burdened. You're gonna like make me uncomfortable too when you ask stuff like that. Yes. I don't have a better, you know, example. But those stuff really happen. Trust me. Which is why having DM'd by people is such a stressful thing for me. And I even drop hints. Please don't simply DM me. If you're like interested in my commission, then that's fine. I can understand that. But like some people, you just spam, you know? Non-stop spamming. I don't know you, you don't know me enough. Why are we like talking? Are you trying to get to know me? Just watch my stream, you'll get to know me, no. I share my life stories there. Do you want to be friends? That's not how you do it. Like, for me, you don't force relationship. It's like that. It's heartbreaking. Please don't do that. Don't put me in such a difficult spot, please. I don't want to be rude to you, or like, I don't want to ruin your day by saying words that you might not want to hear. I had that happen to my stream, to some of my chat. I can still remember your name and all that. Like, they drop huge BTs. I don't remember. It's like months ago. Like, even probably a year ago or so. It's pretty like long ago, right? And then they came back. They'd be like, hi, I'm back. Like a lot of stuff happened in my life. Like, now I'm back, blah blah blah. And then they still remembered that they dropped me such a huge amount of BTs, and they felt like they could DM me because of that, you know? They started to, you know, be disrespectful in the DM, saying stuff like, I think I said this on stream, suck my, you know, suck my chicken or something like that. They did say that, and that's when I feel like, what the fuck? So I removed them from my server and all, and I was also drunk during that time. I remember that was one particular time when I was in the freaking VC feeling drunk and people joined. I still remember who joined, okay? Even though I was drunk, I remember, and some of you are still here. So they have the... They feel like they could say it because they're, you know, oh, it's just Mistia, we're gonna tease her. Oh, it's just a joke. It's not a joke. Please don't disrupt my, you know, privacy like that. And they'd be like, oh, what's going on like for the past few days or like few years, few months, I'm gone, can you share? And I just shared like briefly what happened, and they feel like, oh, I'm here, you know, like you can talk to me. Wait, no, that's too nice. They said it, but in a weird sentiment and in rude words, kind of. Like, I can't exactly quote or like cite your dear words exactly, but I still remember.
I still remember. I remember stuff, okay? It's not that I'm a stranger on the internet. You don't know me, I don't know you. Don't just invade my privacy. I hate that. I hate that people make me uncomfortable, put me in the difficult position where I could barely say no. If it's regarding me, I still can tolerate it, but if you do that to my wives, I'm gonna sit back. I don't care who you are. Has people sent me nudes? Not complete nude. It wasn't even complete nude. Did I ask for it? No. But I'm not sure if you. Out of nowhere, you sent me a picture of yourself. You're taking a selfie in the mirror with your underwear on. Okay. Why? You will know if I ask for it. Definitely. You will definitely know if I consented to it. If I say yes, please send me your dick picture. Giving hints. On the other hand, the ones I always ask for didn't send me no. What is my life? Loving you. Just to be clear, I didn't make you uncomfortable, right? No, this is like good interaction in chat. Right, Alfred, I give your money, you give me art. Yes, that's commissions. Yes, please. Oh my god, I look so pale here, but on my tablet, I look normal. Oh no, this is our song, I just realized. Oh no, Missy, it's not my friend. Oh no, Missy, I don't want to listen to all the fucking stuff in my life, she's so mean. What? That's wrong with people sometimes. There are people, it's just probably internet people, right? But I'm just gonna share what happened to me, at least in my experience. Some people were just in like talking and suddenly they sent me their picture of their face and be like, haha, by the way, this is how I look like. We're not even like few days of talking, you know? We're not even that long. They just sent me a picture of their face. Like, I don't know you don't know me, we're like strangers. I've never heard of you at all. Like, I just literally know you today. They sent me their pictures. And they sent me their Facebook. They even asked me for your number. Oh, what the fuck? I have like a lot of block numbers now. Oh my god. So funny. Still funny to me, but be safe. Hope. Be safe always. Hi Short! Welcome back! How are you doing? The thing I do when I'm on open space pulls out the trauma dump something on me. Hey, I'm sorry, but I can't help find help because search for psychologists is exactly. Unless if it's like my friend, my close friends, my waifus, mostly my waifus. Back in the day, I still have my best guy friend asking me for shishi advice a lot because I grew up with them. We were like very young, like 5-6 years old. We've been friends and. They depended a lot on me, and because I wasn't exactly feminine growing up. I was, you know, the middle child or like the second child. Usually, will have that personality. They're like pretty tough and not girly at all. Like they don't wear pink and stuff like that. I wear my favorite color back then was black and red. I still wear black these days. I just wear black. I love black. Black clothing is nice. But I was just, it's just two colors.
I hate pink. I hated pink, sorry. I like them now, but they don't necessarily look good on me. Tomboy, yeah. Not my hair though, because my hair was super curly, like... Not as curly as afro curly, but it could pause like that if it's so humid. It was that bad, because I grew up with such a curly hair. So I can't afford to have a freaking short tomboy hair, because... You know, it will look like... My head will be like a sponge looking. So I keep it long. But I play all sorts of sports, I fought, I was punched by guys multiple times when I was young because they bothered my friends, so... I was very tough, but now I'm just baby. Just a baby! My inner child is starting to come out! The older you get, right? Your unhealed child trauma, your teenager trauma is coming out bit by bit. So you have to deal with them first. The middle child was shy and reserved. I wasn't, but I was the odd child. I was very weird. My parents always mentioned it to me, like, I'm so weird. Growing up, I'm a little bit different from my other siblings. You still are the old child. Shut up. Yeah, I am. Why? I've got a problem with that. I'm very weird. My mom said when I was a baby. She said I was the easiest to take care of, like, you know how when you have a baby, you have to have full attention to them? In my country, in Asian, most Asian countries, we don't have babysitters, okay? We don't use babysitters, it's not a concept, like, parents will be like, why would I, you know, I can raise my own child, I can take care of my own child, why do we need babysitters? Kind of like those, right? So, it's really hard for parents back in the day to do chores. House chores, move around or like work when they have to like watch out for their baby. But me, she said it's so easy for me. She just turned on the TV, let me watch ads. I would literally shut the fuck up and just watch all of those ads. They fascinate me. Those ads. They don't bother me at all. So she was like, it's so easy to take care of you. But I was often sick when I was a child. I was often really sick. So they got worried when I got sick. Even I'm like growing up, they still got worried they heard I'm sick. My dad like will not sleep well knowing I'm sick. Till this day, he like always check up on me because I get sick. When I get sick, it's gonna be bad for me when I have such a low immunity. To be honest, I feel like I might be the one dying first. Which I don't- I kinda see it coming if it that happen. No one is to be blamed. And I only have that one pair of gown that I really love that I always wear, and my mom had to burn the gown because I wouldn't want to change. And oh my god. And I was as a kid I was pretty dumb with studying, but then I got better just because my sister, you now have someone to compare, to be compared with, so you have to, you know, live up to expectation. Damn it, my sister. She was so brilliant, she was so smart that I had to, like, somehow match her. Just why I lived like this, right? Rank bleach, no joke. Oh my gosh. Was brewing coffee, what did I lose? A lot.
baby stories.
dun, 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 I love you. You love me. So, and go.
I get into fights with the neighborhood kids. Like, I punch them if they punch me. I took some taekwondo classes because of that, but it was so expensive I couldn't like continue, so I stopped until blue belt. So if you've taken taekwondo classes before, you know, like, the end game is black belt. So I had blue, so that means brown tip, brown belt, black tip, and black. So like four duns, or like four levels left. Just such a shame, but it was so expensive. So expensive. My parents couldn't afford it anymore, but I was fine because I have sports to do. I was very active. Knowing myself, I was very weak, right? Younger. So like, I went beyond that. I like challenged myself. I want to die that fast, you know, so I do sports. Do you need to know? Asian parents have to compare. I'm still compared. Yeah, same. Good morning! Good morning, Rai! How was your sleep? We're just talking shit about me. I'm having dinner right now. What are you having? I haven't had dinner yet, to be honest, but I'm not that hungry. I had... If you follow me on my real life, I just posted a selfie of me with my purple tongue. Because I had dragon fruit. The purple fruit, not the white one. So my tongue was purple. I should order more food for late night. Oh, you should. What are you having, by the way? Tom Yum fry. Ah, yummy! I love Tom Yum! Tom Yum is my favorite Thai food! It's so good! It's the colored tongue. I love purple so much, I want my tongue to be purple. Only I love you. You love me. You don't look good. Cinderella. I remember Leo really loved this one. Also guys, I've been thinking a lot lately about getting new mods. Not because I need some modding for my stream. I'm lonely. I wanna know new mods, you know, I wanna have a new team. Yeah, mods? I know, right? Shocker! Understandable though. Most of my mods are more custom to me streaming during EST time. Night EST time. So when I change my streaming time, I don't have mods.
Mod check. Portland. Mitta Mitta. This is Quote's favorite song, by the way. VIPs, run for your life. She will prep you to be mods. The best way to save a VIP badge is to just mod them. Redeem be a VIP. No! Don't leave me! Hey, I sent you the invitation, okay? Let me see. Wait. I wonder if I still keep the invitation? Oh. I sent you the invitation. The official invitation to be my mods, right? And there's no way. There's no way out. Wait. Let me look for it, okay? I will look for it. Where is it? Where is it? Wait, let me look. I know I keep it. I'm looking for it, okay? I'm looking for it! Oh yes! I found it! I knew it! I knew I would find it! I'm gonna show it to chat, okay? You!
Bella?
Okay, you guys should see it. You'll like know what I'm talking about. No, don't lurk yet! Look at this! There. So I sent this invitation to Krovich and Leo.
That shouldn't be.
It's unforgivable.
Can you just show up and be like, I need to work for my money worth? Can you not do that? Oh, this is the... The entire restaurant is closed. Ah! Hey boss, I'm just gonna cook by myself around your establishment.
Yes.
Why not do that? You're also a cook? I didn't know you cook. I feel like there's so much. Do I? I attract a lot of cooks, I guess. Now I know a couple of people that cook. It's interesting. It's such a fresh thing. All my life, I'm surrounded by boys. Due to my nature of education, where it's normal to have four girls in the class and like... a lot of like people that are boys, right? We're basically all doing the same thing. So you actually do croissant! I wanna open all.
Look at that booty, show me the booty. Booty. Give me the booty. Booty, I want the booty. Back up the booty, I need the booty. I like the booty, oh what a booty.
Thank you for the booty. Family food restaurant, what's your favorite dish to make?
Missing this.
If you don't mind me singing this. Do you mind?
I'm a little bit.
Oh, に祈り雨に祈り嵐を今予感しても最後は一つになるのが本当の Peace of Love 出会うための Pain of私という小さな星ひとしずくの愛が芽生えた失うものを恐れては戦えない月に祈り星に祈り行くべき道胸に
Yo! I didn't believe that. That I'm having, freaking concert with people listening to me when just 15 years ago it's only me in the shower. I loved to sing since I was very young. Italian food, mostly lasagna pasta. Oh, wow. Sounds... I'm hungry. I'm hungry. Probably I'm just gonna cook ramen for myself after sleep. You want some GMT minus 3 times when I'm open for it? I like to have power. GMT minus 3? Wait, what time is it for you right now? It grows so fast. Who grows so fast? Not sure if you can hear it. I trust.
どこかで今争を恋がする泣いてる心から愛は生まれない悲しみだけが溢れてしまう美しい海の苦いのかけらから真似て行きたい二人を抱いて夕焼けに染まるオレンジを海には世界の涙が眠ってるララララララララララ
I have a nice day at work, Tubby. I didn't know you were lurking still. Thank you for lurking today. Oh my god, did I? Oh my god, I did not just. Oh my god, yes, I did.
聞こえてた。どんなに暗く辛い場所でも。You're in minus eight? 美しい海の願いのかけらから生まれてゆきたい。闇を開いて明日焼けに染まる紫の海にも私の願いは溶けている。いつか悲しい争いの種全てが消える。そんな日が来て一つの愛を歌いたい。青い海の中で誰かが優しく名前を呼んでいた。私の願いを知っていたように、美しい海の願いのかけらから生まれてゆきたい。光を抱いて夕焼けに染まるオレンジの海にも世界の涙が眠ってる。
愛と
夢が一つになり、悲しい今を星屑にしてくれるから信じて、生まれたこと誇りにして強く光る天使のような眼差しを曇りなせないで、その力夢のために風のなら生まれてきたのいいの。のみたいその勇気眩しい。
Oh, have a good meal!
で、できた光その勇気 の力愛のためになぜるなら最後帰ってゆけないわこの力夢のために風にな生まれてきたの日の愛になりたい
Thank you, thank you. Thank you for coming to my concert. It's a free concert.
다다다다다. I don't even know if I know the lyric to this one too. 다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다다 気がして胸がキュンと切なくなるよ。私を助けて、何かが知らせるデスタニー、星の導きを胸に抱きしめて、それはエヴァブルー輝く大好きなあの夢を、未来を守る力を今集めて、愛すべき人がいて、愛すべき場所がある。未来く青さ、ピュアな気持ちのままで守るために、ただん、星の似てた僕が伝えて、だから今も場にいれるから、信じてみたい、自分を好きになる。I don't know the lyric of this, the second part. イラララメロディー、いつも持ってる平和エヴァフレン、一番大切なものだから、こんなに暗い時を守り続ける、大好きな人がいて、大好きな場所がある。きらめく青さ、ピュアな気持ちのままで守るために、ドゥドゥ。 It's very like high vibe. If we were to go to the karaoke, I might like lower down by minus 2 the pitch. I'm like shading this really freaking slowly. I should hurry up so I can eat.
I don't know this lyric either. Let me just look for the lyric. Do they have a lyric though? Oh, they do. Ding!
Oh my god, Dragonmon! So for you, umare kawaru asa ga kuru nara, onaji inochi wo mata ikitai, megurui aeru subete no mono ga kouseki ni naru kiseki wo shinjitai. Yes, hello.
Kokoro wo hiraita toki, namika ga hajiketa. Itori de koko made kita kedo kitto wo tsuyokatte ta ne. Daiji na mono kizuita de kisetsu ga megurita.
One of these days, I'll sing Chobit songs for you or Kakuto Sakura songs.
So for you, drew, drew, drew. 星に願いをかけた 七つの光見つけ出して 離れになった Jerry Star
let me be with you. Right? 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 You wanted me to sing that, right? Right?
光がきっと出会えるような魔法をかけて、両手をそっと重ねてほら微笑むから、本当の気持ち気づかないふりして、突然二人恋に落ちたの。締めたいの、 yeah, ooh, yeah. Let me be with you. Yeah, yeah. 今までずっと言えないまま隠してたの、強がってるそれだけなの、見つけ出して待ち合わせまで、あと5分待ってて、その後2人恋に落ちたの。繋いだ手をそっと離すとき、不安になるの、不安になるの。
A very long knee. How's that? Is that fine? Brings back memories? Oh, I am a dreamer. He saw the power. What does
私の世界夢と恋と不安でできているでも想像をしないまま隠れてるはず空に向かう危機のようにあなたをまっすぐ見つめてる見つけたいな叶えたいな信じるそれだけで越えられないものはない歌うように咲くのように思いが全てを変えてゆくよきっときっと驚くくらいI am a dreamer. Summer power.
Please tell me you guys know this song.
まだ未の世界そこで何が待っているもしも理想を誓っても恐れはしない鳥たちは風に乗り旅をしてゆく時から明日へと伝えたいな叫びたいなこの世に一つだけの存在で私になるように星のように小さな光だけどいつかはもっともっと強くなりたい限界のない可能性がここにあるこの手に It's gonna be your world
My tarot cards are actually Sakura cards
見つけたいな叶えたいな信じるそれだけで越えられないものはない歌うように奇跡のように思いが世界を変えてゆくよきっときっと音吹くくらい
It's platin platina platinum
It's cut up the Sakura songs.
They're like great. My tarot cards. I used to read them, but I left all of my cards at my sister's.
Na 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 na.
I don't know this song. I should like finish this hurry so I can play. Okay, fine, but I won't come back. Ah! La 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 la! What do you guys think? I think I'm almost done. Trying to see where I'm missing stuff. Now I don't have to really worry about missing Christmas stuff again. Work time! Oh, I have a good one! Thank you for being here, Rai! Ah, hello, Sammy Nico! Welcome back! Gothic Santa, I was about to say, addresses purple solo with a red cap? Oh. I think it's a good, model, design. Greetings? Hello, yes, hi! let's cry! Ah, such a good anime. I wanna rewatch this again. Who wants to rewatch this with me? It's very shoujo, very old, very 90s style.
Nandomo kiteru yasushi ano melody itsumo onaji.幸せが溢れる毎日何かが足りない気がしてたそう偶然あなたに会うまであの日の気持ちはいつでも思い出せる雨の夜も夢の中もどんな時もでも伝えたい言葉素直に言えないからしまったままもう少しいいよ
Oh, hello, Mikuzu, welcome back!
あなたの話した言葉は柔らかな風のように包んでくれる なんとなくそばにあなたがいるだけでいろんなことできるような気がするよどんな夢も叶え
か言えるその日まで、ずっと一緒にいられたら。Oh, did Kitty end the nursery? Oh, Kitty end the nursery. Kitty end the nursery. Hope you guys enjoyed that. That was one of my favorite childhood songs. For real. It's so good. The anime is so good as well. I'm looking for songs to sing. I like this song. I don't think they have the karaoke version. If they don't have, then we're just gonna play the normal song. But I have the piano version.
きな大きな声で笑えたら、
Oh, I like this.
作りまでこ一緒に笑ったね。
I need to do more covers.
手をつないで歩いた道、今日は二人で抱き腰を、君といるとどんな世界も明るく輝くよ。そんな君の隣にいる、こんな小さな幸せを一つ一つ抱きしながら笑顔に変えるよ。道のように
I miss that.
ハッピーな夢もいつまでも。
such a short lullaby, so I'm probably gonna, like, cover that one day. One day I'll cover the song for you guys. We'll have more songs in my playlist. Really good anime is song. Very old one. I really love old anime. It's called 小さな魔法王. Small magic. Isana Maho. Oh. Oh, wrong song. It's this one. They don't have a karaoke version. Ding, ding, ding. It's such a good song. Aizu wo kawasu no. Ashita mata aeru yo ne. Sore ja sayonara mai di. Sore sore no madobe kara.同じ空を見て、ドゥドゥドゥドゥドゥドゥ、約束を祈って、心そっと合わせよう。So old. この夜空のその向こうを、二人で描く。それは秘密、誰にも秘密。小さな魔法。If you understand Japanese, the lyrics are so nice. それは秘密、that is a secret. 誰にも秘密、no one's secret. It's a small magic. La 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 la.Good anime, very cute. This is the opening song. Very happening.
na 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 I might miss you 愛することと愛されること違いはしてはいれない I wish Hello wake up angel 胸の中の口の目覚めて I wish Hello I say love you 大好きよずっとI wish you to tell I love you. Thank you for believing me.
I don't even know. I just sang by memory, I guess. I think I'm almost done with this. I think this is perfect for our last song.I don't love the lyrics as well. Knowing God and I say, hey, yeah, 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 hey, yeah, yeah. I say, hey, what's going on?What's going on?
And he tries.
Oh my god, do I try? I try all the time. In this institution.
And he prays.
Oh my god, do I pray? I pray every single day.
Yeah.
Forever will shine.
Perfect, right?
Hey, yeah, 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 yeah. Hey, yeah, yeah. I say, hey, what's going on?
I think we're done here. I will add more, but then I'll like continue being hungry. And it's like almost midnight right now. Oh my god. Turn off my filter. What the heck? Oh, it's autoplay. Stop. I actually had a playlist open, which is the Undertale. So off.
ダダダダ。OK! パドル、パドル、スズカネル。イェーイ。パンいい感じでした。The paddle art. After a while. Oh my god. It's so long. I'm sorry. I'm sorry it took such a long time to finish this. 3 hours, wow. Wow, imagine. Swimming for 3 hours. Okay. Let's rate. One of my favorite artists. you guys should watch her. She's about to reveal, like, she's waiting before, she's gonna have a live 2D new model debut. Well, what am I saying? I came back at the end of the stream. 2 hours, not that long. It's pretty long in my book. Okay. Yes, yes. You did. Dragomon, sorry. But thank you for being here. First time since. I know, right? But thank you for coming back, by the way. Welcome back. And. thank you, Rexo. I'm gonna write Mimi Chair. So, if you follow Mimi Chair on her Twitter, she is currently, she's gonna debut her new model soon, so help her retweet so we can see her model, you know, reveal together. And thank you for stopping by, thank you for hanging out with me, and thank you for just, you know, chilling with me and talking to me in chat today. Such good conversations. It was very nice today. I enjoyed it very, very much. Thanks for this free as well. Eat well. I might snack. Just snack. Ah! Thank you for love. Thank you for love. Oh. Next time. Come here then! You're my snack! Bye, Ruritz! Good to see you. Thank you for hanging out with me and everyone else. Thank you. Good night! Been a while. Good night, schlaf schön, schlaf gut und traum süß. Oyasumi nasai. One an. Mir mir tau tau. Kyowa totemo tanoshikatta desu. Thank you. Bye, everyone. Take care. I'll see you tomorrow. Probably for Minecraft. Bye! Bye! Bye. Oh no!
Let's rate this fellow Lolita. Yeah, this is, this artist is called Tewa Tewati. Oh, gotta rate it. Oh, ちょっと